Thank you for joining us and welcome to React Masterclass. My name is Boris Passgaver and I'm a full stack developer, educator, author, and consultant based in New York City. I'm super excited to introduce you to the ins and outs of the popular React library for building single page applications. So without further ado, let's dive right in. First up, what is React? React is an open source JavaScript library for building dynamic, reactive user interfaces. What does it mean to be dynamic and reactive? It means that React applications can adapt to change. React applications can adapt to user events, such as the user clicking or typing or navigating. React applications can react to events like receiving data and re-rendering a fragment of the screen, but only when that data is received. That's what we mean by dynamic and reactive interfaces. We mean applications that change over time seamlessly and easily and elegantly for the user. So React is an open source project, so it has a wide team of open source contributors, but it is sponsored by Facebook and Meta as well, so it has the backing of a large enterprise company behind it. So what React does is it updates the visual elements in your browser application without forcing a page refresh. We're going to talk more about exactly what React does in the next lesson, but for now, all you need to know is that React is the most popular single-page application library out today. It is the most popular way for you to build dynamic front-end interfaces right now as a front-end developer. And the proof I can give you of this is just how popular React is in the real world. So here are some examples of companies that are utilizing React today. Facebook, Instagram, Reddit, PayPal, Airbnb, Uber, Twitter, Dropbox, Venmo, and thousands of other companies and code bases all use React. If you need to learn just one front-end technology today to be an employable, productive, knowledgeable front-end engineer, React is definitely it. So with that said, let's quickly talk about the prerequisites that you'll need to know in order to begin this class. I want to make sure that you have a good foundation of basic front-end development before diving into this course content, because we are going to try to focus as much as we can on React itself. So you need to know the basics of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. You do not need to be an expert in any of these technologies. You do not need to have years of experience. You just need to know the role they play in a general web application. You need to know that HTML is for creating the structure of a web page, and you need to know the basics of how to do that. So you should have some prior experience, for example, declaring an unordered list with list items inside a div, etc. You should have basic experience with CSS. So by that, I mean CSS declarations, writing CSS styles, targeting elements by their ID or class, some common styling properties like padding or margin, etc. You don't need to be an expert once again. You just need to know the basics of how these technologies work. Same rule applies for JavaScript. You just need to know the basics, declaring variables, the data types available in JavaScript, working with arrays and objects, some common methods, and some modern ES6 features like destructuring, class declaration syntax, and more. For many of these concepts, if you need a quick refresher, we're going to introduce these concepts as we progress throughout the course. We're going to only give you kind of a brief review, a very quick overview or refresher on how these things work. So if you need to learn these concepts in greater depth, I recommend doing so before you begin this course. In addition to that, you'll need to know some basic knowledge of your terminal or command prompt, whatever is your command line application that you're using on your computer. So just folder navigation, outputting the files in the current directory, creating files, deleting files, etc. And finally, some basic experience with Git. So making commits, checking out to a new branch, reverting your work, etc. These are all kind of fundamental tools that you learn when you start out as a programmer in general. So I hope it's not too much. But if you feel good with these technologies, then you should be good to proceed. Other than that, I'm going to assume absolutely no knowledge of React or any kind of single page library out there. So we're going to begin from scratch, and I'm going to show you step by step why React is the most powerful and dynamic library available today for building front-end interfaces. So lots of fun stuff up ahead, and I will see you in the next lesson.